I okay if we can please stand?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you for coming tonight. Abby is going to introduce our first speaker.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to our winter concert. It's so nice to have such a good audience here tonight to see all the music we've worked on this semester, the orchestra and chorus and vocal groups and jazz band. Thank you. Please remember to silence your cell phones, please. The first piece the orchestra is going to play tonight is the theme from one of my favorite television shows. It is a supernatural Netflix original called OA. And the plot is very complicated, so I'm not going to try to explain it. And frankly, I don't think many people would find it that appealing, which is probably why I didn't get a contract for another season. But part of the show is about traveling through time and space to alternate dimensions. I know, it's crazy. But the vehicle of transport is described as an invisible current that you have to willingly jump into and let it take you to wherever you end up. And I think that we could all use a little of that nowadays, especially with seniors applying to college and anything else that anyone has going on in their lives that they provoke stress or worry, that we could all use a little leap of faith, just jumping into something, letting it take you wherever you may end up. So I invite you to keep that in mind as you separate yourself from all the outside distractions and let yourself be here and then use it. Thank you. Enjoy the concert.
This next piece is one of our, well, maybe our fastest piece from start to finish. And so that's posed some challenges, but I think that the orchestra has had a lot of fun playing this and practicing it and performing it. So I really hope you enjoy. Here is the number one by Joseph Hayden.
So the next piece we'll be playing is Beating the Beast.
And I picked the song because when I think of Disney music, especially Disney princess music, I think of when I was a little kid, watching Disney princess movies with my sisters and dreaming about how I was going to be a princess. And I'm not a princess now, but I still find a lot of that magic in Disney music and especially Disney princess music. So I hope that you guys find some of that magic in our piece tonight.
That was really, really good, right? Jane's going to introduce our next piece. What piece is it? Part 2.
Hello, everybody. Our final piece for you tonight will be called Jupiter, Bringer of Jollity. It was composed by Gustav Holst in 1914, and it is the fourth of seven pieces that make up a suite called The Planets. The two planets left out are Earth and, sadly, Pluto. And it is a great piece. It's a lot of fun to play because it's very regal, named after Jupiter, which is the Roman name for the Greek god Zeus. And I hope you enjoy it. It's got a particularly recognizable part right around the center, so listen out for that. But before we get to that, we have a little surprise.
Thank you. please get a round of applause.
I really wasn't planning on applying this, but last week we went to Liberty Place. And Beth Johnson was there. And Corinne Sellers, it was wild, man. And because when we play, you know, usually nobody watches us, you know. So parents, right? So it was so cool that they were there, but like when we played this song, Beth was grooving. I was telling myself, she was really not. She said, you should play it anyway. So we played it tonight anyway. And I hope you enjoyed it. And you know, the reason that I thought this was possible, because like I timed our program, because we were trying to make it short, because we don't want you to be here until 11 o'clock. So we had like 17 minutes of people for music to play. So why not add a little bit more? So this last piece is so wonderful, and you'll be so happy that you're here tonight, not streaming at home, because you can't hear all the delicate intro timbres of all the instruments. So I'm so glad you're here, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you so much for being such a great audience.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we sang it for a couple of months, just singing 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3 until it kind of got in our blood. And now I feel like I can't sing it the normal way anymore. So, and now you can't either. You're welcome. Our next piece is actually looking ahead to Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Up to the Mountain, also known as the MLK song, is a gospel folk song that was written by the singer-songwriter Patty Griffin, who's one of my favorites. And it's basically, it's in a gospel style, and it's based on the speech given by Martin Luther King called I've Been to the Mountaintop, which he delivered in 1968, the day before his assassination. And it's really, the lyrics are beautiful, the song is beautiful. If you've not heard the original sung by Patty Griffin, I encourage you to do that. It's also been recorded by Solomon Burke and Kelly Clarkson, and probably others. So I hope you enjoy our performance of Up to the Mountain.
Mountain, because Sometimes I lay down.
No more can I do.
No more can I do.
But then I go on again. As you ask me to.
Some days I
I'm not Before I turn things over to the vocal groups, I would be remiss in if I did not thank our fabulous accompanist at my right hand in rehearsals, Zach Bateman. I realize we didn't get to show him off nearly enough on this program, so I'll try to remedy that in the spring. And also, I want to thank in advance the fabulous vocal group students. You're not going to hear from me after this, you'll hear from them but I want to thank them already for the great leadership that they've shown in really choosing repertoire, rehearsing repertoire, arranging repertoire, leading rehearsals. They've been fabulous. So this is the last you'll hear from me, and this is Beth Halehu.
Yeah. Oh, Rocky had come, a quick gun, to shoot up the legs of his rival. His violent scene, I broke in his dream. I see her on the girl I respect me. Her name was McGill, she called herself Lil. And everyone knew my sexy. Now she and her man, they call herself Dan. We're in the next room at the hotel. And Rocky burst in, grinning in her grin. I said, Danny boy, this is a showdown. But Danny was hot, and he drew my section. And Rocky, the mouse, and the corner. Yes, give me the boots, give me the judo. 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 The doctor walked in, stinking of gin, and proceeded to lie on the table. I said, Rocky, you met your match. Rocky said, doctor's only a scratch. I'll be better, doctor, soon as I am able. So Rocky Raccoon, he checked back into his room, only to find Megan's bottle. Gideon checked out and left a note out to help with the Rocky's revival.
Sunday morning, rain is falling, falling. Skin, cover chest, no shade.
Skin,
flash the travel dust with moments unforgettable. You twisted from the mold behind me. That may be all I need. And darkness, he is all I see. Come to rest your bones with me. Driving slow on Sunday morning. I never want to be too.
Bye,
I do.
Make it count, play it straight, don't hesitate. When you go big time, watch your run, watch your feel, never quit. Make it feel when you go big time.
If it's your lid when you are a kid with fairly odd parents,
Thank you.
is at home. I think he's still awake watching the stream. I just want to tell him how much I love him.
Aww.
I hope he sleeps well tonight. And I was thinking about this as a parent. How it must feel to come and hear all this beautiful music. It's gotta feel so good. Can we just get everybody you've heard so far a round of applause?
So
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worry on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear a pitter-pat? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. So, On the Sunny Side of the Street is really a love song, and it's about how love can make you happy and make you see the sun on the other side of the street. And for me, it's been a love song about music and playing with this band. And I hope you guys think about what makes you really happy and what brings you out when you hear this song.
Thank you.
So this song, they're coming to be playing, he's like about Sally. It's also a love song, but I think. But it's one of the songs, every week is a stand-up song. So it's one of the songs, usually a practice where they're sitting down with their stands. And we have one song where we stand up every practice we play it. And it's usually the song that gets us the most hype and gets us really excited, and we're really uplifted to play it and really excited. And I hope our song makes you want to get up out of your chair and also dance along. So enjoy.
Hey, did you know it was Beethoven's birthday? My man, Beethoven. So check this out. It is also Lily Ford's birthday. If this was a normal jazz band rehearsal, I would sit down at the piano and improvise personal version of happy birthday for her based on my interactions with her, her being the kind of wonderful student she is. But it's not. So what we're going to do is we're all going to sing happy birthday to her. Can we have a seat? There we go. Everybody, come on now. Okay, here we go. Ready?
Happy birthday to
thank you.
Few of the students in our band have actually learned some solos right off of the recording, and they're super difficult, and so I just want to, you know, say I'm really proud of us for pulling it off, and like, we've ramped up the tempo in the last couple weeks before the concert, and we've all handled it, like, I think, pretty awesome. And, you know, I don't know, we'll see how it goes. You know, hope you enjoy it anyway.
Thank you. Harmonies, And what that means is that everyone needs to be listening to not just what the song means to them, which is incredibly important when you're trying to solo on such a complex piece, but also to what everyone else is doing and to be really involved in the dialogue that is playing jazz. And that's why I brought it to our band, because I knew how much it means to them to be together, which is why tonight I'm wearing this locket, which has a photo of Lindsay and Benny from this one time I was late to jazz band rehearsal. I got there at 7:30 a.m. instead of 7 a.m. So they rightfully so reprimanded me. And so without further ado, I hope you enjoy Shane's song.
Thank you. We are, I think the students want to say something, but there are refreshments. This is important. Across the hall. Wait. Does anybody want to talk?
Actually, someone's not trying to talk.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.